Hello guys, it's G-Max from G-Max Studios and we are here with another amazing tutorial on how to create this beautiful portrait. We got a lot of comment and requests to create a grid that will go very well on a light skin model or a light skin person, and we decided to do this video. So thanks to everyone that has supported this page so far, that has liked, subscribed and also shared. We love you with the whole of our heart. Okay, all right. So we have been able to finish the frequency separation, dodge and burn. Okay, this is like the part 3 or the part 4 of this segment, and we actually lost one of the parts, which was the part 2, which was talking about the skin toning, but maybe in another video we would fix that up for you guys to see what it does and how great it can affect your image and help your image look better, look more professional. So back into the business of today, color grading this image. So we are going to go to our adjustment layers, and then I will go for my selective color. And okay, now remember that there are two major colors that actually affect your skin tone. We have the red and we have the yellow. So on your selective, if you want to work on whether a dark skin person or you want to work on a light skin person, you're particular about these two colors because they can change your game in your color grading for any of these skin tones. Okay, basically I would want to move my cyan towards my minus to be able to have that glowing feel, and then I could move this up a bit, just little, and then I want my reds to pop. Yes, I want my reds to pop. Then I would go back to yellows. I come to yellows, and then I will still increase my yellow, but for my magenta, for this cyan I would increase it, but for my magenta I will bring it towards minus. So I'm trying to get that orange feel on the skin, the orange feel on the skin. That's what I'm trying to get right now. That's why I'm actually reducing this magenta towards the minus. So, and then I would add a bit of the yellow to give me that thickness of the yellows on the skin. So it's like our before, now after. It has done a great job so far. Let's see if I move this a bit, will I get, okay, I actually don't want that, so I'll do my Ctrl Z. Okay, most of the times for me, I just would want to try one or two things even while I work and all, and many of the videos I do, I actually create them here, so there's no practice beforehand. So if there are things I'm trying to do, just maybe learn from it or move forward. All right, okay, then I'll go over to my color balancing. Alright, I will be working with my mid-tones, my shadows and my highlight. And note that this image is, let's say, like a 3D image. That's why you're having all this depth and all. And so, that's to say, we have both our highlights, our shadows and our mid-tones. And you want to take note of them. So, for our cyan, under our mid-tone, we are going to increase our red a little bit. Yes, and then I would increase my yellows. Okay, then maybe I could increase my magenta. I want my mid-tones to be filled with skin tone colors, colors that pertain to the skin, that will make the skin look good. Okay, I think 7 is fine. It shouldn't be too much. Okay, and 7 is fine. Yes, so I'm going on a 7, a minus 2, a minus 7, and I'll go for my shadows. I will not go towards my reds anymore. I'll rather go towards my cyan. Be able to bring in depth, and then I'll add a bit of my blues. Be able to bring in depth to my image. Yeah, yeah. Okay, alright. Let's add our greens for our shadows, and then we come to our highlights. Yes, this way. Finish work. Okay, so based on the mid-tones colors we added, I want to cool it all down. Then we go here, voila, that just changed the whole game. So I'm actually using 15 for my cyan, and I'm actually using 22 for my my blues, and then I could maybe add a bit of yes, I could add my magentas. Let us add more of this. Yes, so this is before, after. You've seen how the image has been able to come out because you have been able to separate them. You have been able to separate the shadows from the midtones from the highlights. That is magical. Okay, all right. And the next thing I'll be doing is I'll be going to my color lookup. Now, for those of us that know about color lookup, they change the game. There are different colors to different kind of feel, different kind of grading, different kind of atmosphere. And if anyone tells you that and the maybe color are not good, maybe they are saying maybe particularly to something. But for me, I see color lookup as godsend, will I say so? Because it helps to most of the time fasten our work and all. But for today, we are going to actually work with the color lookup, and don't be scared. We're not going to just we don't have to import. This is okay. By the way, this is how to import your color lookup. By when you go in here, you click when you go when you get to your load 3D loads, you just click on load, and then you go to where you have those loads. Myself, I have some loads, but after working with that, I would actually use the inbuilt loads on Photoshop, and then I would go to my four colors. I'll pick my four colors. Now, I love my four colors because of the way it falls on my skin. Now, yes, it's falling on the background and all, but look at the way it is giving my skin that glow, that orange-like feel. But right now, it is, first of all, it's too much. But apart from that, it is not giving me depth. So for me to get the depth and for me to get it only on the colors, I will change my blend mode to colors. Yes. So this is like before when it was in normal, and then after and on color. So you see how it enters into the image. For me to be able to get this grade enter into the image, then I have to do that. So I will now reduce this here. I want it thick, so I will leave it that way. Okay, it's at 46. 46 is fine. This is like before, this is after. Okay, it is still cool. I could leave it on the background, but if I would want it on the subject, I would basically want to invert this. Yeah, I don't want my background to be affected by that grid. Then I'll use my white. Remember, white reveals black height. So when you're working with your layer marks, you know that okay, this guy is on white, then if I want to hide it, then black and vice versa. So I would come here and then with my white brush, and I would have to check if opacity is 100. I want to 100, and then I'll brush it in. Let's see, just fall on my script, my skin. All right, so that is beautiful already. We've gotten something. Okay, yeah, this is cool, this is beautiful. So this is like my before, this is my after. Why I love this, it makes my things my skin thick, makes it come out well. So this is like one top secret that I learned over the years, and it has really helped me, and it has helped my photography. It also I apply most of the time even in my dark skin model to not just make it looking dark, but make it have this chocolate kind of feel and make it glow. So if you're looking to upgrade your game, you can also use this. So I'm actually using the 2020 Photoshop. So if you're not seeing it on your Photoshop, that's to say we are not using the same Photoshop. But I think 2021 and 2020 and 2019, 2018 Photoshop would have the four color. Okay, so that's that. So, and lastly, I would, okay, the second to last, I would go to my photo filter, and then I'll change my photo filter to full filter. Okay, so you see how it helps to cool down all the red, your boosted, all the yellows, everything, and then gives me that cool feel. So let's just skip it again. Okay, all right. So yeah, let's help me calm the environment. Okay, for this video, I would also give you a plus on how you fix the eye whitening and teeth whitening. Okay, my first step to eye whitening is I'll go pick up a huge unsaturation layer, and then I will reduce my saturation all the way down, not totally. Yes, and I'm fine there. And then I would possibly go and get a curve, and then I would increase it a bit because I notice that my eyes is looking a bit dim. But when I do that, I want to add a bit of contrast. So you see, I'll come reduce it here. Now, this is actually affecting my image, and I'm not actually seeing what I'm doing because it's affecting everywhere. So what I do most of the time is I'll let's delete this curve layer. Once I reduce my opacity for my saturation, for my huge unsaturation, I would invert it, Control I, and then I would come back here, and then possibly I would want to brush on the eye with white, then 100 I'll brush. So yeah, you see the work we would do and how to actually fix this eye and what we are adding and why we are adding what we are adding and the intensity of what we'll be adding. Right, so let's just concentrate about the eye for now. Okay, I've been able to take the colors off, but it is not looking appealing, it's not looking bright, it's just dull. So for us, we have to do that is we'll add curve, and then we'll mask the curve. So one way to do it is say click this icon here, or we click mask it by holding your alt, and then in between the two layers you would see this icon will pop up, and then you click on it, then to automatically mask it. Now what you're trying to do is you're saying that this curve should no longer stand on its own again as a dependent layer. You want it to work with this layer here. So only what is revealed on this layer is what would be shown by this curve. So if this guy is not exposing any other area, it will not show any other area except the place that this guy. So this guy is the boss here. He's deciding where they go to and where they don't. So on that note, I would be able to add my brightness and it will not affect everywhere, only where the user addition decided or decides. Okay. So and then I'll add a bit of the contrast to be able to give me that depth in the eyes. I think I'm still seeing some colors. Okay, yes, we have been able to work on this, but it's still not there yet. One other thing we can add is looking for a way to blend to make this eye look white. And I think I've gotten some WhatsApp messages saying that, okay, how can I fix a white picture or something like that, making it look white. Okay, now what I'll do is I will go pick up photo filter and still I'll click mask it again holding my alt, and then I will go to my blues. Now before after, see how it made a huge difference. It has now made my image look far better, right? So I would reduce this a bit. Good, very good. So I could just add this a little bit. Okay, then I would still come here and then I would brush in for the teeth to be able to use. But for the teeth are already looking bright and all. So I don't want it everywhere on the teeth. So I will just come back here and then I'll brush here. Okay, so I guess you're not seeing the effect, but let's see. For NAFTA, for NAFTA. So that is how I fix my teeth or my eyes in Photoshop. Okay, we're actually supposed to do this first. Let's rename it eyes. Okay, we're actually supposed to do this first for the color grading board. Since the video was for color grading, that's why I went straight into the color grading. So we would actually move this down here because it blend. Where is it? Okay, we'll take it, let it be on its own. Okay, so now the color grading has also affected the eyes, so it has made it blend. Now not on anymore. So back to color grading. And lastly, we are going to add our curves. So, and you see how it made a huge difference. Okay, this is really, really amazing. So this is how you can quickly grade a light skin model and make it pop in Photoshop. Alright, so we have been able to work on this image from the frequent separation to the bone, the dodge and bone, the eyes, and then we have the color grading that makes image beautiful. But on the other hand, I also have a LUT that is available right now, though we are still working on the set or the pack for both light skin and dark skin models. So if you want to purchase it, just also indicate in the comment section and we would do well to drop a link for as many that would want to get it. Okay, now so how we're going to do that is we are going to show you how we can use that and immediately get what we want without going through all the stress of grading the way we just did, which is I would off this color grade, and then all I'll do is I'll just go pick up a color lookup, and then there are actually two looks for the light skin. We have one that is light, yeah. So if I just add a bit of curve, you will notice that voila, the image has popped, and also this has already given you a good blend of what you want for the skin. And then our second grade, that's also enhances the skin even more. So this is quite beautiful. So you could as well just reduce it to get the desired production you want or desired grade you want. So if you have noticed, this is just one LUT and you're already getting an amazing skin. So if you think that this is lovely, you let us know. So that is how we create a light skin model. Alright, so so far we've been able to do all this, and thank you for watching. We have come to the end of today's tutorial. So if you like this video, please do well to share, do well to comment. Already we are getting massive support, and we want more of this support. So if you can share to friends that you know are having issues with grading light skin models and have been looking for a solution, this is the solution for you. So whether you want to buy a LUT that will be able to give you what you want, or you want to learn how to grade yourself, we have it all for you. So if I were to add this LUT, then you get to see something amazing. So it is all here for you. So also do well to subscribe to see more videos that will be dropping on this channel. Thank you and have a lovely day.